Hello, welcome to the Doom Rooms. Actually, this is not the Division of Obscure and Unknown Miscellany. It's just my home office. But I hope you enjoyed seeing some of the props from Unnatural History. And welcome to the 10th anniversary tribute. I'm really proud to have made a show in which kids could watch with their older siblings, their parents, their grandparents, and their friends without ripping their eyeballs out. A show in which the characters were always witty, smart, well-read, resourceful, curious, and loyal to each other. For those of you who have seen the show, I hope you like this glimpse into the past, and for those of you who haven't, you're gonna see a little bit of what you missed. Enjoy.
My name is Henry Griffin. I've spent my whole life living in exotic places, and I learned a great many things. I also had a habit of getting into trouble. A lot of trouble. So to keep me safe, my anthropologist parents shipped me off to the one place I'd never lived, America. Now I live with my uncle and cousin trying to fit in at Smithson High, a school inside the National Museum complex. I work in the museum's basement where they store all kinds of weird stuff.
Where were you raised, in a cave?
Only for a year. Want to know what I've learned so far? No matter how hard I avoid it, trouble always seems to find me.
Henry Griffin is the new kid in town. Although he acquired some incredible skills living overseas, he knows nothing about urban American life. I guess you could say he's the proverbial fish out of water who prefers to be with actual fish in the water and not saddled to a desk at school. Henry's challenge is to navigate the mysteries of high school while remaining true to himself.
Don't you worry about that. Only scientists, PhD students, and military personnel get to go in there. You think you can handle it?
Your fault you got me sleeping in one. Now I can't sleep in anything else.
You are keeping your old life in balance with the new better than you think, Henry.
Yeah. Got a dozen texts from people talking about your dramatic entrance this morning.
Jasper Bartlett is Henry's rule-bound and hopefully Yale-bound cousin. He's also got some incredible skills, like working the academic system to his advantage. But having Henry as a roommate turns his world upside down. He tries to help Henry understand that being in the urban jungle isn't the same as being in an actual jungle, with marginal success.
Henry?
Hey, that's my locker! They hit my locker?
No. My laptop is gone. Okay, under normal circumstances, I would never say this, but you are faster, stronger, and braver than I am, so I am begging you, go get my laptop! Go! My life is on that machine!
Who's the smartest person you know that we can trust?
Sir, please, don't high-five Vitarkamutra. He's an ancient symbol of peace and love. Not one of your homies.
Come on, Maggie, we just need a minute.
It's never a minute with boys.
Maggie Winnick is Henry and Jasper's best friend. The smartest person in the entire school, Maggie's photographic memory, linguistic skills, and ability to use logic to solve the most impossible riddles makes her a huge asset.
My Futhark is a little rusty. Roughly, it means when summer solstice starts the day, Odin's compass lights the way?
That's because it's the address of our school. Smithson wasn't just always a school. It was a Civil War hospital, a convent, a mental ward, and for one short year, 1934, it was the temporary offices of the FBI.
On the other hand, she can be socially awkward, and being that smart can be kind of annoying.
Sorry, occasionally I get nervous when I don't have a plan. And when I don't have a plan, I can periodically get nervous. For example, I might get nervous when someone I care about is being held hostage and we don't have a real plan!
All right. I said I have proof.
Where is this poison blow dart?
Well, I had proof.
Well, now you're grounded. And if you don't shape up, Virginia Boys Academy is only an hour away. Make that 55 minutes, because when I'm agitated, that's how I roll.
Uncle Brian is the adult in their lives. Often fooled, but never a fool. Brian's a single dad doing his best to keep his son and nephew safe and on the straight and narrow. Despite somehow living with two impulsive teenage boys, he always maintains a sense of decorum, even when he loses his patience, his job, and his freedom, and quite possibly his sanity.
They called. A volcanic eruption just grounded all the flights out of Asia. They're not coming. But there's a silver lining. They get to miss my indictment.
Oh, actually, they don't.
We passed about a dozen of these alcoves. What's so special about this one?
I smell seawater.
The writers went to great lengths to research actual historical events before putting on a fictional twist. Where is the U.S. Navy's first submarine, which sunk in 1863 at the height of the Civil War? And was it really carrying $1 million in Army payroll gold?
Look at all the stuff he found. Oh.
The submarine, it's right here.
There really are alligators in the sewers.
Did Sputnik 1, the first satellite to orbit Earth, really burn up upon reentry? Or did Henry Jasper and Maggie find it in an old museum crate? The answer must be yes. Why else would Russian assassins be following their every move?
Just go! Go, 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 go! Just drive, I'll catch up! Run, 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 run!
Jasper! Give it all you got!
Okay. So maybe Ponce de Leon never found the Fountain of Youth, but did he discover a super performance-enhancing plant instead? And if so, could this exotic plant finally lead Smithson's lame basketball team and Jasper to athletic glory?
The water. It must be full of berry juice. It is a drug, and Dr. Ortiz is experimenting with it on the team. Make sure nobody drinks anymore. I have to stop before he gets away with the plant. Where did I go wrong? Which one of you is tricking me? Ben Franklin, you were never even a president.
In the show's finale, Henry learns all about the Founding Fathers working at Mount Vernon. But did Ben Franklin really build an atomic bomb in an effort to end the Revolutionary War? And if that's true, maybe it wasn't such a good idea for Henry to put it back together just to get extra credit.
Is my future in this box?
We also got away with moments we never thought would get past the kid bid sensors.
It must have been important if it was hanging from his tribal nipple bolt.
Morneau is pierced. That's just beyond wrong.
Fire!
Why didn't you just shower at the dig site?
Because I know your tricks. I at least left you a towel. You would have left me with nothing.
Actually, I had planned on a tube sock.
Yes!
That was 6 years ago.
Was it? Yeah, I guess when you load your shorts at your own birthday party, it feels like yesterday. Thanks for being my butt posse.
Your what?
Somebody you can count on to cover your rear end. The girls call them BFFs. Never mind.
Hoover cut off his instrument? If you mean this instrument, yes.
How much oxygen is there in air compared to, say, the average expulsion of flatulence?
21% air to 4%. Jasper, no, don't you dare fart.
Henry? Jasper? If you're trying to get me to cross the border into Jockstraplandia, the place where no decent girl dares go, it won't work.
And there's going to be plenty of room for you on the plane.
Plane? What plane? Who said anything about... You can't be serious.
You took off again on a mission that clearly was none of your business, and you nearly got killed.
But I found the hikers.
and I'm fine.
You've lived everywhere else in the world, Henry. It's time to go home.
Washington.
And let's not forget the great Canadian character actors in recurring roles, including Jack Horgan and Scott Jaffe as Henry's parents, Vas Saranga as the Doom Room's Broxton Garko, Robbie Amell as Mike O'Malley, probably the last time Robbie's ever going to have to play a dumb job.
Loser.
Matt Baram as the Birdman of Smithson High, Professor Julian Morneau. Wesley Morgan as Huntrow Herlihy, another thorn in Henry's side. Rosemary Dunsmore as the Dean's ever-vigilant executive assistant who has a crush on Henry. Weird. And Colin Fox as Henry's beloved godfather and unfortunate murder victim.
Happy 10 years to Unnatural History. Wow, what a fantastic show.
Happy 10 years. Happy 10 years.
Thank you. And happy 10th anniversary.
So just want to express my joy and happiness and just say how excited I am for the 10-year anniversary. I wish we got more seasons than one, but it will live near and dear in my heart.
I can't believe it's been 10 years since Unnatural History. That's actually nuts. I have a child.
Making me feel old.
It's crazy. Doing that show was the first big role I ever had.
It's the reason you didn't have to go back to school.
That's true. I didn't go to law school because of you. Thank you very much. I love you. I love that show. I wish we could rewind, do it all over again. I wish it lasted longer. It's like chocolate covered broccoli. It's good for you. Taught you things. I know a few Jeopardy answers. I think I got Sputnik in a Jeopardy answer because of the show. Anyway, we love you. We miss you.
It's been 10 years. That's bonkers. We all exchanged emails and we wanted to make a couple of little thank you videos for the people who watched Unnatural History. Thank you. Thank you for watching the show. My phone's on. Just told me I have low battery. I will be forever grateful that I got to be a part of that series.
Ten years ago, I rode a horse through a park and delivered a life-saving vaccine to a school full of sick children. 10 years ago, I rediscovered Sputnik with friends and thwarted an international KGB ring. 10 years ago, I wrangled an Egyptian cobra and stopped an assassination attempt on my brother, Tamba. 10 years ago, I had the chance of playing Henry Griffin thanks to some incredible friends, Mike Werb, Ty Ricci, Jordan Varis, and Martin Donovan. 10 years ago, you have some of that champagne?
Yeah.
This shirt fit. Happy 10-year anniversary on Natural History.
Well, I hope you all enjoyed watching this blast from a decade past. Unfortunately, Unnatural History is still not available for downloading or streaming on Apple TV, Amazon, Hulu, Netflix, etc. But maybe in the next 10 years or so, it will be. Thanks so much for watching.